Cantalbert was a juggler. Every morning he would walk to town with his equipment, unpack his discs and hoops and balls, and juggle. But he could never attract an audience. He tried new and difficult tricks. But nobody paid any attention to him. Then Cantalbert thought that perhaps if he were more religious, perhaps if he wore a hair shirt, heaven would give him an audience. So he went to the market and bought carrots and string and scissors. And Cantalbert made himself a hair shirt. But still, he could not attract an audience.
One of those in years. And Talbert was a failure. He realized that the world would never change, and in 50 years he would be dead and turn into dust and blow across fields and blow into people's eyes. And his pink and cocoa hoops and discs and balls would mean nothing, nothing at all. He had always felt that juggling could reform the world and that social inequalities could be resolved. Instead of arguing and fighting, people could learn to juggle. If only he were a monk. He could be far away from the unhappiness of the world, and he could pray to the statue of Mary in the monastery chapel. He could tell Mary how sad and lonely he was, and she would understand. He could live in a warm room and have friends.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
He packed up his things and went to the monastery.
Besame y abrazame, marido, marido mío.
Y daros
en la mañana camiso limpio.
Y daros
en la mañana camiso limpio.
Yo me encargo, mi amigo, estar tan muerto. Y aterré, ya me digo, estar no despierto.
Andad, marido, alerto, y tened brío.
Y daros
en la mañana camiso limpio.
Y daros
en la mañana camiso limpio.
Yo nunca, yo me digo, estar tan muerto. Y aceré, ya me digo, estando despierto. Besame, ya besame, marido mío.
Y daros
en la mañana camiso limpio.
Count Albert visited the monks in each of their cubicles. One monk cooked.
Ah, magnifique!
Another wrote prayers and poems.
There was an old curate from Kew who kept a tomcat in a pew. He taught it to speak. Alphabetical Greek. But never got farther than mu.
Another brother made sculptures. Another of the monks composed music.
Count Albert wanted to fit in, but he couldn't even say an Ave Maria or sing an Agnus Dei. He felt useless.
He was asked to help by teaching Sunday school. He was asked to assist the sculptor by cleaning the studio.
Mm-hmm.
The next day, he was told to help the cook. He was to prepare and cook a goose for dinner.
Oh, ça alors, non. Mais regarde ce que tu as fait. C'est invraisemblable. Enfin, c'est une belle oie et tu as tout gâché. Oh non, non, vraiment, quand on est servi par des gens comme ça, hein, c'est beaucoup. Mais c'est épouvantable. C'est un imbécile. Il a tout mis de travail. Oh non, 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 vraiment. Et puis en ce moment, j'ai beaucoup d'autres ennuis. Et puis il y a les gens qui viennent dîner. Et toi, tu... Oh,
zut alors. Quel imbécile!
The brothers complained to the abbot about Cantalbert, but he was permitted to stay if he would do odd jobs for the monastery. He did the dishes. Carried the groceries. He helped to decorate the chapel. And swept the halls. Soon it began to snow. As Christmas approached, the monks retired to their cubicles to prepare their gifts for the Virgin. The cook cooked, the violinist wrote music, the sculptor sculpted, and the poet wrote poetry. But Cantalbert didn't know what to do. Weeks went by, and soon it was Christmas. Everyone went to the chapel to present their gifts. Cantalbert went last because he had nothing to give Mary. The first to present his gift was the cook. He had baked a cake entitled The Church Triumphant.
Bravo, bravo.
Outstanding, outstanding, bravo.
Next, the poet presented his gift. He read a long Latin poem that he had composed.
Adorate Dominium in decore santo, quia petra meae munito mea tu es, in manu commandavo spiritum meum, in mano tua tempora mea, ostande faceium tuam super senum tuum. Salve in misericordia tua, peccatum meum notum factio tibi e iniquitatum meum non abscondo. Ecce oculi Domini super timentes eum, et expectantes misericordiam eius.
Then the sculptor presented his gift. It was a monumental statue of the Christ child.
Outstanding. Bravo.
Bravo. Excellent. Excellent.
Bravo. Excellent. Outstanding. Bravo.
Bravo.
Bravo, excellent.
played the violin, was the last to present his gift to Mary. When all the monks were asleep, Cantalbert tiptoed into the chapel.
He did all the best juggling tricks he could think of.
Juggled all night to entertain Mary. The next morning, the monks came back to the chapel to admire their gifts, and Cantalbert collapsed with exhaustion.
Was it insane? What a shocking, what a sacrilege, what a horrible...
Insane!
Was it shocking, what a
outrageous,
monstrous!
But suddenly, the great statue of Mary moved and bent down and gave Cantalbert a rose. It was a miracle.
Oh, miracle! Hail Mary, glory to God!
How great! How wonderful!
How wonderful! How great!
Our own miracle!
Thank you. Almost ready, no consent, I can't be people, I'm getting people.